Simply Done, the podcast network.
Gotta lay off the stuff, Scaremaster. You can't keep having this stuff around me. It's I can't work like this.
Okay.
I feel like I'm being...
Stop
I'm
fucking
being
doing
forced,
it, motherfucker.
I'm being forced to do this stuff out of peer pressure from you and your cool Hollywood friends is not happening for me anymore.
What's going on?
Scaremaster's pressuring me to do narcotics.
I'm not pressuring you to do shit. I'm trying to get you to quit.
Really? Really, Scaremaster? You're trying to get me to quit? You just want to put me back on the streets and make me work doing $20 half and halves like you did to make your bones.
Okay,
oh
this
Can
is...
This
just shut
show?
Up. This is... Talking to the fucking mic, first of all. I can't hear you.
Hey, Dan, I thought we were all done making that Big Three podcast. What's going on?
Are we done with the show or no?
Just shut your fucking mouth. Yeah, we're done with the show. I told them originally we would go till the end of the year, so I'm putting out a couple best of shows, and that's what this is.
This is great.
Okay.
You know what my favorite thing we do is?
What's that?
Just being together, talking about personalized pop culture.
That's what we've done for over 3 years now.
But I also love this song.
Coming to you pre-recorded from Simply Down the Podcast Network Studios at a secret location in West Hollywood, California. It's the Big Three Podcast. Hey, everybody. I'm your old pal, Don.
I'm Mole, Tony Barbieri, whatever you want to call me.
And I'm suffocating because this fucking prick on the other side of the room started smoking again.
Excuse me, okay, Scaremaster. I ask you to treat me with some respect, please.
And
respect! Respect is when you don't fucking both smoke in my face!
It'd be nice if you gave me just a modicum.
Just a little bit. That's all he's asking. Just a little bit of respect. Well, this is a best of show, and what we're going to do here today is we're going to play some clips, but today's clips come from a very special person. Let's see if Perry can guess who this person is. All right? Who would we want to kind of showcase in this show?
Marlon Brando.
All right? I said Mole. 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 Okay. I said Perry. Now, Perry, who are your guesses?
I already said Lisa Marie or Terry Anfuso.
No, it's neither one of those people. All right. He's more of a fan. Does that help you out at all?
Oh, I know who it is.
Oh, do you really? Do you?
More of a fan?
The president?
No.
Of Argentina?
Not the president of Argentina. Any guesses? Before
no
I tell you? All right, I'll give you one last clue. You probably hate this guy more than anybody else.
Oh, his brother, Brian LeBrand.
I still don't know.
Did his brother special guest star his brother?
No, we tried to get him, but we couldn't get his brother. No. I'm going to try one more time. You hate him more than anybody who's written here.
Demetri Moreland and Huey Craig III.
Demetri Moreland is exactly right.
What?
And on the phone right now, we have Demetri Moreland. Say hi, Demetri.
Hello, Perry. So great to finally talk to you.
Hey, Demetri, oh that's nice.
Demetri, you're a big fan of the show,
Master,
huh?
Be nice.
I'm a huge fan of the show, and I just want to say right off the bat, I love you, Perry, and I want to be with you more than anything.
Hold on. You fucking animal! Put the fucking headphones on! How can you hear the phone call if you don't have the headphones on, you fuck?
He's got a little bit of a point. Scaremaster's got a little bit of
Put the fucking headphones... Take the fucking hat off.
I'll hold your hat.
You're not gonna hold my fucking hat!
Why not?
You've already poisoned it enough with
what
your
mean,
fucking...
poisoned it?
With your fucking grubby fucking hands.
All right, Demetri is trying to say something to you. Would you say that again, Demetri?
Go ahead, Demetri.
Yeah, what's up, Demetri?
Perry, I just want to pour my heart out to you. I want to say right off the bat that I love you. And
thank
I just,
you.
I think about you all day,
yeah,
every
you
day.
You're sick.
Just last night, I had a dream about you, Perry. In the dream, we were 69ing on a beach
You're
on
disgusting.
A hot California day. The frothy surf was crashing over our bodies. We were sucking
You're grosser than shit.
So hard.
You're gayer than shit.
Scaremaster, he likes you. He likes you.
I don't give a fuck if he likes me.
Well, it's flattering.
He's a fucking homo, and I want nothing to do with the gay people.
How about this? How about you have some professionalism and hear what he has to say first?
Let him talk.
Okay, go ahead.
So you seem to be a big fan of the show, Demetri. When did you first hear it?
I'm a huge fan of the show. I just want to specify that I'm not gay either. There's only one man in the world that I would fuck, and that's Perry F. Caravello.
So you've never been with
You're
another man?
You're not gay, huh? You fucking lying sack of
shit. I've never been with another man, but I want to give my anal virginity to Perry Caramello.
He loves you, Scaremaster. Dude.
I don't give a flying fuck. Nobody is ever going to touch my body again.
Why do you like Perry so much?
I love how he plays so hard to get. He just plays these games with me when he says stuff like this.
Oh, God.
And it just makes me want him so much more.
Why don't you give it a shot, Scaremaster? What do you got to lose?
Fuck off!
You know what? Maybe we could do this. Why don't we role play a little bit here? Why don't we say that, Demetri, you are Demetri Moreland, casting agent.
Can I set the scene? Can I set the scene?
Yeah. You want to do a little role play with Demetri?
Yeah. Can we try
okay.
it?
Okay. Oh, it's time for the favorite thing that we do on this show. It's time for a little mole play.
Mole play, let's play mole play. Mole play, let's play mole play. Mole play!
Okay, we're going straight up Desert Island. We got Demetri, we got Scaremaster. They've been there for a long time. They got no clothes left on. And
they're
walking around.
Wrong.
They're thinking about ladies. They bump into each other. Mole play. Oh, Demetri, you play Demetri. Scaremaster, you play you. You're on a desert island.
You're on a desert island, and you're just the two of you. You're completely naked.
And you just bumped into each other. Mole play.
Oh, God.
Demetri.
Perry, I just want to tell you, this is a terrible situation. We're stuck on this desert island, but there's just no one I'd rather be here with.
Next. Go away.
I think we're soulmates, and there's no
We're not
here,
soulmates. So. Get it through your thick fucking gay ass head. We are not soulmates.
He likes
you're
you.
You're a homo. I give a flying
He just
fuck.
Said he wasn't.
You're a homo. You're a lying crack of shit. If you're fucking writing me gay shit, you're a fucking homo. Stay away from me. Don't write me again, because I'm going to block your fucking ass. You fucking homo. Stop it.
Oh, Perry.
Scaremaster, it's yes
like that,
and.
What's going on, Demetri?
Keep yelling like that, Perry. Oh, that's what I like to hear, baby. Tell me how bad I've been. Come on, Perry.
Are you aroused right now?
Oh, that's such a hard cock right now. I wish Perry could see it. It's throbbing right now.
I would chop it off, you fuck, and shove it down your goddamn
Perry,
throat.
Oh, Perry, that's it. Play with me hard, Perry. Chop it off. Suck it. Chop it off and suck it, Perry.
He likes it when you say that. Keep going, Perry.
Perry, keep going, please. Come on, Perry. Don't blue ball me, Perry. Perry, I need this. Oh, my God.
It sounds like he's really close, Scaremaster.
Just help him out.
I'm done.
Perry, I'm close, Perry. Oh,
Scaremaster, you're on the desert island, right?
Hole.
And you haven't seen any ladies or anybody.
No ladies.
The first person you've seen in years. You're like, hey, man, what's up? So just talk
in
to him for
years?
A second.
In years? That'll never happen with me.
You're in a desert island. That's
I don't care. That'll never happen to me.
It's improvisation.
I'll never be on a desert island.
Right, but in this
by
scenario,
myself
we
with
are.
That other fucking
that's
guy.
What, how
it's
do you know?
Imagination.
What if you two were on an airplane and the plane went down
happen.
And you were the only two that
never,
lived?
It would never.
Oh, there's never been a plane crash before.
Not with me in a plane.
Yeah, well, you never know.
Well, that's why I don't fly
all
right,
the time. So the plane goes down. You're on this desert island. There's only you and one other passenger. Everyone else died.
It's not going to be Demetri Moreland.
What if it
Perry,
were?
There's no women around, Perry. No one's going to
Sorry,
find
buddy.
Out.
No one's
going to.
No one's
going to.
It's just you two.
Oh, well. I'll kill myself if that's the case.
Well, anyway.
Perry, can I tell Perry something real quick?
Absolutely, and then I've got something I'd like to do, but go ahead. Tell him what you got to say.
I think we're soulmates, and I think Perry, he just needs to open himself up, both emotionally and physically for me.
It'll never happen, Fat.
Listen to him. What's that? I didn't hear that part.
Perry, you know how you used to detail cars? I want to tell you how much I have in common with you and that it's not all about sex.
Okay.
I also want to detail your asshole with my tongue.
No,
Fat,
no
I want to
no,
stick it in
you.
There so deep.
No, thank you.
Swirl it around that
Sorry.
Tight Italian butthole.
Sorry.
Oh. I want you to feel it sliding up and down
no
the wall
way.
Of your asshole. And on your prostate.
I'll take your fucking. I'll take my fucking.
I'll
take my dick
my
and crystal cherry knife and chop your fucking tongue off.
The crystal cherry knife.
Do it, Perry. Slice it off and then stick it in your asshole, Perry. Stick my severed tongue
he
so
really
deep in that hole.
Bleeding severed tongue
he
in my
really
ass.
He really likes you.
You're disgusting.
Why do you say he's disgusting? Because he likes you?
He. It's gross.
It's more than life. I love Perry Caramello.
It's gross. It's the gay. The gay talk he's giving me is grosser than shit.
Can I ask one question?
Just, of course,
and listen, Scare Master, this is for both of you guys. And I know, Scare Master, like, this is completely antithetical to everything I represent and what I feel towards guys. But why not take, like, a 2 or 3 night carnival cruise to Mexico?
Fuck you!
Would you do that, Demetri?
Fuck you!
I'm not. I would love to do that. I would carry Terry's bags, and I'm going to fuck him
you.
So hard. So from here to the shores of Mexico.
I'm not interested in going to Mexico.
You wouldn't have to carry your bags. He'd carry them for you.
I don't have a fucking passport.
You know what I think
and I'm not interested in going to Mexico, too. Especially with a homo named Demetri Moreland.
Well, here's the great thing. Because today what we're going to do on this best of show is we're going to do nothing but play clips of $10 shoutouts that you've written to us, Demetri. Does that sound fun, Mole?
Yeah, but can I just clarify one thing? That's because of the gay thing, not because it's a carnival cruise, right?
Both.
You don't like carnival cruises?
I don't like going. I don't like gays, and I'm not interested in going on a carnival cruise with only gay guys.
No, it's a regular cruise.
Wait a minute.
You guys are traveling together.
I'm not traveling with this guy. It'll never happen.
Harry,
it'll never fucking happen.
All right, the two of you, Rosarita Beach, parrot on your shoulder.
I don't give a fuck.
Let me ask a question. Don't interrupt me. Demetri, let's say that we convince Perry that he should go on this carnival cruise, but let's say he didn't want to have sex with you. Could you hold back from having sex with him on a 3-day tour?
Yeah, that's fine. I mean, I don't have to have anal sex with Perry. I can suck his dick. He can suck mine.
It's not going to happen, you faggot.
We can jerk each other off with
it's
our feet.
It's not going to fucking happen, you fucking sick, perverted homo.
Scare Master, you guys...
You're a fucking perverted homosexual that I want nothing to do with. Stay the fuck away from me.
You guys can just make out.
He's the fury.
Never.
Okay, so here's what the show's going to be about. This sounds fun. This is going to be nothing but Demetri Moreland $10 shoutouts. You ready to do this, guys?
Totally.
Why don't you introduce the piece, Perry?
No.
Why?
Because he's perverted, he's disgusting.
He doesn't want to start to be too
know
Moreland.
All
he
wants got to do.
He wants to finish.
All it's got to do with is the way that fucking homo wants to have gay sex with me. It'll never happen. So fuck all he is.
Okay.
God, I love that he plays so hard to get. It just makes me so my cock just got way harder.
Okay, so why don't you hang out, listen to this with us, and this is the history of Demetri Moreland and his $10 shoutouts. Let's start out with the very first time that you ever sent a $10 shoutout.
$10 shoutout!
All right, Perry, you read the next one.
Add on pack.
Anytime, Perry.
Salutations. Sometimes I wonder why I'm so attracted to the big three. But I think I finally know who. My platonic feelings toward Don and Mole stem from Dom's matinee ideal. Idol. Good looks and graceful leadership. And Mole's warm-hearted demeanor and adorability. My feelings towards Perry are more lustful in nature. He's very attractive, but in a really dirty, slutty kind of way. He's the kind of man that you just want to ride all night. Paint the interior of his rectum with your semen and make him clean you off with his mouth afterward. With the way he teases and tantalizes. It's like he's asking for it. In my perfect world, I think I would be married to the big three. Jehovah's Witnesses are cool with polygrams, right? Oh, polygamy. What the hell is that?
I don't know. You're reading it.
But I think I can settle for the big three podcast. Demetri Moreland.
Okay.
Whatever.
By the way, have you ever thought of doing
books on tape?
Because you have the absolute perfect voice.
It's pretty interesting.
Very soothing.
I'd like to get him to read The Godfather by Mario Puzo.
Ooh. Maybe sometime we should read
forever.
Yeah, maybe we should do like a paragraph or a couple chapters at a time.
Maybe when you're in the hospital, we'll come in there with the tape recorder and you can just read The Godfather.
Excellent idea.
And we can put that up as a special podcast and get sued by the Puzo estate.
If you want to, if you want to get us all sued.
$10 shout out.
Okay, this next shout out will have Perry. The pages are kind of stuck together.
Dear Perry, thanks for reading my letter last week. When you offered for me to come out to L.A. to see you, I got so excited that I came all over myself. I decided to send you something special this time. Did you notice that this letter is a little sticky? I smeared my jizz on the page to give you a little piece of myself. Rub it on your body and get used to how my semen feels on your skin. Feel free to lick it too, because you're gonna be doing a lot of that when we go back to your apartment after our night out. I can't wait for you to give me the tour of Hollywood's gay night life, but the biggest draw will be afterward when we make love all night. I'm planning on coming over or coming out sometime after the big Randy Hallicanahan. Take this fucking.
What, you didn't finish it.
Tough shit. Well, I look.
What?
I want nothing to do with that subject. I want nothing to do with these fucking faggot celebrations. I am. Don't even ask for me for the month of June. From June 1 to June 30th, I'm gone.
Where are you going?
Don't worry about it.
Oh, TMZ's going to be all over this one.
Where are you taking? Are you doing a festival without us?
That's what he's
doing. I'm going away.
I'll bet you don't. I'll bet you're doing a festival.
He's doing the Chicago one.
How can I go do a festival when I don't?
That's the one that's throwing money around.
How
like
can
crazy.
I do a festival when I don't have a fucking pot to piss in?
I don't
or when
know.
Or
well,
to throw it out of.
Okay.
I got some pot.
No, I don't think he means. Well, to finish this letter, I can't wait for you to give me the tour of Hollywood's gay nightlife. But the biggest draw will be afterwards when we make love all night. I'm planning on coming out sometime after the big Randy Callahan celebration in June. See you soon. Demetri Moreland.
Keep it. It's yours. It's a faggot film.
$10 shout out.
All right, and this is the last letter.
Dear Perry, thank you for reading my letter. Last time, I apologize for being up or bringing up Randy Callahan's name. I understand that you don't want to talk about past lovers. He was not my lover. He was a fucking employee. Okay.
Yeah, he worked for Scaremaster.
I worked for him.
Well, he was employer.
I was, I was employed by the guy. All right. As an extra on two shoots.
Yeah, three shoots. I understand shoots that is what you don't. I get.
Fucker. I understand.
You know what?
You
hold on. That was about, funny. You got to admit that was funny.
I don't want to talk about past lovers and respect that. So let's talk about the love between. No, I don't have any love for you, Demetri. You and I starting. Let's see. I'm starting to prepare for my trip to Hollywood to see you. What kind of lube do you like? Fuck off, faggot. Water-based lube is always nice, but with the amount of sex you'll be having with the girls that I'll be getting, we may need an oil-based lube to keep your ass. are you an all-natural kind of guy? Yeah, natural with pussy. Our natural juices may be all we need on our trip down the. I don't want to even say this.
What is it? It's a hard word. Sound it out. Just
Hershey Highway. Always, you don't have any problem with swallowing a load, right? What? A load. Not a load from you, you fag. I don't expect you to give me at least nine. This guy's a fucking homo. I'm here and I'll get angry if you don't swallow. Dude, I'll fucking bite your. Never mind. I will also expect at least three rim jobs. Fuck you.
How many should he expect?
Zero from me.
Well, I don't know.
This is all in addition to the intercourse I'll be having with some hot babe that's not in this letter. Thanks again for inviting. I never invited you out here, Demetri Moreland.
I mean, well, why do you throw things? What does it really say?
Why are you so angry at the guy?
Because the guy thinks I'm a faggot, and the guy thinks he can come over to my house and have faggot sex with me. He's not going to get any sex with me. He's not going to come anywhere near me. If I meet him once, yay, big deal.
All right, so one time, see how it goes.
So it's a one-night stand, not a busy.
No one-night.
He's not asking for a relationship, dude.
Well, you just said if you
if
meet him,
if I meet the guy once,
hey,
yay, good luck.
Yeah, there you go.
Hello, and goodbye.
Right, have fun. You have a good time.
$10 shout out.
All right, go ahead, Mo. Read the next.
Here's a new letter. It says, Dear Perry, when you read my letter last time, you sounded excited about me coming out to see you, but you were worried that I wouldn't fully commit to you. Let me assure you that I'm 100% committed to our relationship. I make good money.
Stop. So who is this?
Not only
male
will I support
or female?
You sexually, but financially as well. Also, I hope this doesn't freak you out, but I want you to get pregnant. They have the technology to do it now. Have you seen the movie Junior? Wow, what? If they can make Arnold Schwarzenegger pregnant with Danny DeVito's baby, then they can do the same for us. So it isn't just about sex, even though we're going to be doing it nonstop at your apartment when I come out there. What?
Who the fuck is this?
I don't know. I do have to stress one thing, though. When you S me off, you better swallow my load. If you don't, I'll get really
angry. Let me say something.
And I may even slap the S out of you. See you soon. Sincerely, Demetri Moreland. The text is for Don.
Not invited over at my house.
The text below is for Dan only. Should I read this?
Yeah, I'm an open book.
Okay, Dan, I'm currently having a lover's quarrel with Perry. He disrespects me.
What?
He deleted me from his Facebook. He has not added me back. So please do not allow him to have my shout-out money. Thank you.
That's fair.
Demetri Moreland.
Okay, here's one.
Air Master, you got to work things out with this.
Look, I'm not dealing with. I'm not dealing with faggots that
want to
fucking sleep in my apartment. I don't want to hear about none of these cocksuckers.
Don't want to hear about it.
Yeah, it's your own personal life.
Your personal. We do talk about our personal lives.
That's true. We should probably. And what is it? Pop culture, I think. Yeah.
The fact about Demetri Moreland, he's gayer than a $3 bill.
I don't see that side.
All he wants to do is fuck me in the ass. And about me using the F word, the F-A-G, you know, the you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But about me using the F-A-G word, I'm going to stop saying that word because it's offensive to all those out there. And I know it's been getting me in trouble lately. And can we mask over the F word and use a different word in
this? What
are
you talking about?
Meaning... Change where I say the word
Say the word what?
Faggot.
When did you say that?
Through all the tapes that I've heard and that I've been a part of course, every time I use the F word, you know the word that I'm talking about.
What word are you talking about?
Faggot.
Okay, go
on. I can't say that any longer.
All right, well then don't say it. You just said it.
I've been instructed to not use that word any longer.
By who?
By my publicist, Tom Brennan.
Okay, but what about the calls that we've heard so far?
The calls that we've heard so far by Demetri Moreland, they just gross me out. I don't want to be a part of his life.
So you don't like him at all?
In any sexual manner. I love the fact that he's sending us $10 shout-out money. Yeah, I appreciate that. Yes, he's a fan. Yes, I appreciate that. Do I respect him as a human being, as a person? Yes. As a gay guy, no, I have no respect for anybody that goes against God's will.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Okay. Well, let's listen to some more.
Fine with me.
Play the next one.
$10 shout out.
Anyway, we've got one last $10 shout out. Why don't you read this
one? Oh, wait. I'm sorry. The Elvis lights aren't on. Could you tell that story again?
Eat me.
That's how it started.
Dear Perry, I'm glad that you want to have children with me. I'm going to send you some pills that you'll need to start taking a week before I come out to see you. They will prepare your body to accept the pre-fertilized egg that I'm going to inject into your abdomen with a syringe. It will hurt a little bit, but Demetri Moreland keeps just bugging the fucking shit out of me.
Read the fucking $10 right. Shout out.
Start from the top. Dear Perry, I'm glad that you want to have children with me. Yeah, what chick is this? I'm gonna send you some pills that you'll need to start taking a week before I come out to see you. They will prepare your body to accept the pre-fertilized egg that I'm gonna inject into your abdomen with a syringe. It will hurt a little bit, but to make you feel better, I'll give you an injection in the butt, but it won't be with a syringe though. Are the Javajos okay with having children out of wedlock? If not, we may have to set up a hasty marriage before you give birth. Number one, faggot, there's none of this shit happening.
He wrote that?
Yes.
Is this you commenting on it?
That's me. That was my comment.
Okay.
No,
it's confusing when you do it like
next
that.
Next paragraph. I would also appreciate it if you could convince Don to be the godfather of our child.
Yes, I will.
I think he would be a very positive influence on our son or daughter. You could even do a Big Three podcast from the hospital while you're delivering the baby. What an episode that would be. Our child will have all the opportunities in the world with Daddy Demetri, Mama Perry, Godfather Don, and Uncle Mo. Yeah, right.
Oh, my God. That's looking awesome.
I'm looking forward to this.
Be sure to let Christina she's going to have a little stepbrother or sister. She may not be my blood daughter, but I care about her, too.
Oh, that's
love
nice.
You, Demetri Moreland. Perry is still being naughty on Facebook. Please don't let him have my shout-out money. Well, guess what, Demetri? Go fuck yourself. One. Two. This will never happen. So don't even think about it, you fucking cocksucker. And you're being booted off of Facebook as well as Twitter. I'm blocking you on all pages.
All right, well then, that was today's $10 shout-out.
$10 shout-out!
Here's another one. Dear Perry, this is to you, dude. Before I come out to see you, I wanted to go over the list of... Oh, you know who this is.
Who?
I know who this is. This is the guy who's been saying who's coming out to visit Scaremaster.
Oh, the one that's going to sleep at his place?
Nobody's sleeping over.
Nick
farther
is.
Than Nick.
He's napping. Before I come out to see you, I wanted to go over the list of sexual favors that I expect you to perform
to make sure
that we're both on the same page. I'll be in LA for a full week. Okay, Dan.
This is really sad.
It is. Okay. I think he's getting mixed signals from his Scaremaster. I will be in LA for a full week so we can spend all that time together. Please clean up the apartment before I get there. I don't want to be rolling around on dust bunnies while we're having sex. Here's the list. 34 BJs. 25 BFs.
What's a BF?
34 BJs. 25 butt Fs where I see inside you. 10 butt Fs where I pull out and see on your back. 15 butt Fs where I pull out and see on your face. 10 butt Fs where I pull out and see on your T's. 14 RJs. Those are rim jobs. 23 H jobs. 15 foot jobs. 5 titty Fs. I think your man boobs are big enough for us to do this. We'll also be showering together and making out and stuff like that. This list is negotiable. There you go. But don't try to jip me or we're going to have a problem. Anyway, I can't wait to see you. And I got you a present, too. I bought us matching leather jackets with both our names stitched on. Just think about how cool we're going to look together. Love, Demetri Moreland.
Demetri Moreland. That name keeps coming up. You guys, he really likes
Demetri
you.
Demetri Moreland can go fuck himself.
Okay? Wait, I don't think he's going to have to with his list.
It seems like you got a lot of activity. Demetri don't spend Moreland, all your energy Demetri on Moreland. This sex stuff. You got Demetri a show to Moreland, do on that Monday.
Look, I'm going to split his fucking head open as
well. Whoa. Listen, you guys keep the specifics of the acts yourselves. That sounds rough.
And that was today's $10 shout-outs.
$10 shout-out.
Now, let's see here. Here's our first one. Dear Perry, sorry I couldn't make it out to the big show. I had a really bad herpes outbreak on my penis, and it would have hindered my ability to make love to you. Everyone on Facebook keeps saying that we were a perfect couple. God. If you could guess who this might be, who do you think it is,
Perry? I have no idea.
Okay, I'll read on. Some of them have asked if they can come to your apartment when we're having sex so they can watch and masturbate along with us. This gave me an idea.
Sleepover.
What do you think about me and you filming a porno together? We're going to be putting on a real sexual marathon anyway. We might as well film it and make a little money, right? Do you know who it is yet?
If it's a male, no. And if it's a female, no.
So what is it yes then to? All right. I'd like to integrate some of our latest special effects in our adult film. For the anal intercourse scenes, we put a miniature camera inside.
You're laughing, so it sounds like a guy.
Well, I'm just saying he comes up with a great idea. We'll put a miniature camera inside your rectum. That way the audience will be able to see my penis goes into your ass and fills it with creamy goodness. Then we'll switch back to our normal camera, and I'll pull out so we can see the anal cream pie in all its glory. I still like to end the video with the traditional money shot, though. I keep imagining how beautiful you look as I'm grabbing you by the hair and busting a nut all over your face. Love, Demetri Moreland.
What a fucking faggot, my God.
He's put a lot of thought into it, though, Scaremaster.
But I will say this.
He is such a fucking homo.
I can understand why Perry might say that. A lot of stuff he said in that letter could be taken that way.
Please, but you know what?
I'm going to delete that motherfucker on Facebook. And I'm
Scaremaster, it's a little flattering. He's pretty persistent about you.
I don't give a shit. He's a fucking pain in my ass.
Well, he cares about you. It's clear
he does care
about
you.
I don't care. I just don't care. I want him gone.
$10 shout out.
The point is Perry is not gay, so please stop sending gay things to him. All right, here's our next one. Dear Perry, I heard about how you gave sexual favors to Jim and Andrew when they had lunch at your apartment.
I didn't do any sexual favors with Jim and Andrew at my apartment.
I don't know how he would have gotten this. I'm fine with that as long as you only blew them and ate their asses. We agree that you would save some of your anus for me until I make it out to L.A. And I'm going to hold you to that promise.
What promise?
That you're going to save your anus for him until he makes it out to L.A.
Sorry.
So I'm saving all my anus for you.
There you go, Mole.
You're my love slave, so I expect you to follow my orders, especially when they pertain to sex with other men. If Jim and Andrew are listening, I have a short message for them. Stay away from Perry's anus. You want blowjobs? You want rim jobs? That's fine, as long as you pay. But the anus is my property. There's no trespassing. If you think I'm going to let two pretty boys roll into town and get a piece of that hot ass before
what?
I do, you have another thing coming.
You got another thing coming.
Anyway, it sounds like Jim and Andrew paid you pretty well. Nice job, Perry.
Yeah. I need to use the restroom real bad.
No, you don't. Just stop. We're almost done with the show. Shut the
fuck
up.
Hurry up.
You can get my cut of the profits when I'm at your apartment. I can't wait to get over there and make it into my little whore. Love, Demetri Moreland. What is going on with the two
this
of you?
This fucking faggot, man. I can't stand his fucking... He calls me constantly. I get prank
he
phone calls
He likes
from
you, dude.
I don't give a fuck.
Well, Perry, here's what you do. I've said
delete the fucking guy completely out of my life.
How can you delete him out of your life? Here's what I would do if
I blocked him on the fucking computer.
Here's what I would do with you.
I gotta change the number. I know I've been getting prank phone calls like crazy.
Scaremaster, you gotta understand, this guy really likes you.
I don't give a fuck.
Well, what about his feelings?
He doesn't have a fucking pussy. He doesn't have D cup titties.
I know, but he still has feelings.
I know. I don't give
someone
a fuck.
Someone puts their heart out there, you know?
Yeah, what heart? That's not a heart.
Let me ask you this.
That's some guy's dick that wants to get in my ass.
What if he
had
What if he had an operation and got D-cup titties? Would you like him then?
Shut up.
You just said that's what...
Is that the end of $10 shout?
He's not a chick. And even if he had a sex change, I wouldn't like him. It's women only. God damn it.
What if he went and had the whole operation?
Again, women only.
Did you just belch?
Yes.
But you've been with many post-ops.
I've been with many women.
Yeah, women now, but used to be men.
Fuck you, Fruit Loop. Never was I with a man.
Yes, you were, dude.
One.
All right.
Anyway, one. That was today's $10 shout-out.
Because of getting in trouble with a San Andreas lookalike on a film set. All right, okay. Okay.
Hey, can we stop talking about all the dudes you've been with for one second?
One!
Who were those two guys he was talking about, Perry?
You're saying Andrew Langley and somebody else?
You were with those guys?
No. I was never with another man.
Then what's he talking about?
It's all bullshit. It's all bullshit. It's all people writing shit to try to make it look like I'm gay. Like I've been with a bunch of guys. Now, what Mole's been saying is that I've been with a bunch of guys. One fucking occasion that happened to me, and
Why are you bringing that up? I know it, but I ask you to stop bringing it up.
I try not to even bring it up.
Why'd you just bring it up?
Because they keep bringing it up on the fucking tape.
All right, they brought it up. It was brought up on the tape, but that was from before. Why are you bringing it up now?
I'm not bringing it up now.
You just did.
What? Oh, jeez. You know what, man?
What?
You just said...
I didn't say it. Mole said it.
The tape said it.
Mole's in the bathroom right now, and I don't know what he was feeling at the time. But I'm saying that was a long time ago.
That's right.
All right, well, let's
move forward.
Forward. Okay. We'll ask Mole when he gets out of the bathroom what he meant. All right, let's listen to some more of these Demetri Moreland $10 shout-outs.
$10 shout-out!
Oh, here's a nice letter for Scaremaster. Dear Perry, I had another dream about you. We were back at your apartment, and things were getting hot and heavy. Where were we made out on your
Demetri
couch?
Demetri Moreland.
When it came time for me to F you, I pushed you down, ripped your shorts off, and slid my C between your cheeks. Unfortunately, we had gone out for milkshakes earlier. Oh, and you had a nasty case of diarrhea brewing. You warned me that you had to S really bad, but it was too late. With one quick thrust, your anus swallowed my throbbing H-on.
Never
in
a zillion years.
And your B muscles started to contract about me, sending feelings of pure ecstasy through my body.
Never.
As I plowed your A, the room was silent except for the queefing of your anus. And it wasn't long before I came inside you, shooting gobs of semen into your rectum. At this point, I felt that something wasn't quite right. When I pulled my C out of you, a flood of diarrhea S mixed with semen spilled on the floor of your apartment. A stench filled the room, and it was so bad I started vomiting uncontrollably. I could hear you begging me to stay as I staggered towards the door. Then I woke up. I believe that every dream has a meaning, but I haven't figured this one out yet. Love, Demetri Moreland.
You predicted that from the very beginning of the letter. You really know how he
that
writes.
That dude.
He's disgusting.
He likes you.
I can't stand him.
He does like
you. I want
you.
Nothing to do with him.
Clearly he likes
you.
He likes you.
Gone.
You just don't even appreciate the fact that you have a fan who likes you.
Oh, I know I got fans that like me.
There you
but
go.
But if you're going to like me.
But he really
you
likes
you.
Like
you like you want to fuck you. Me in the ass, you fucking faggot.
Dude, the guy like you likes you. Likes you like he like you. You know what I mean.
I'd be honored. He's disgusting. I really would be honored. Anyway, let's move on.
What did he do?
Oh, Christ.
Can I just say one thing to Demetri?
Go ahead.
If Perry gets you blue, here's what you gotta do.
Well, that song is kind of a catchy song. The more I hear it, the more I like it.
The more I hear it.
$10 shout out.
All right, here's another $10 shout out. Dear Perry, because you're so good looking, how about you have to deal with fag hags all the time? These are women who are extremely attracted to gay men like you and me. Just last week, I was confronted by a female employee at a gay club that I own and manage here in Chicago. She told me that she was in love with me and then started to take off her top. And then he says, like I'm supposed to be turned down by those two big sacks of fat hanging off someone's chest. I told her to leave, but she did not stop. Then she pulled down her pants and showed me the female vagina. It was disgusting. It looked like an Arby's roast beef sandwich that got left out in the sun. I don't think that's true. I was about to vomit when a couple of my boys came up and escorted her out of the club. It's crazy how some people just can't accept a person's sexuality and leave them be. I am not, nor will I ever be, a heterosexual. I know you feel the same way, Perry. Love, Demetri Moreland.
Again. All right. That's it. You're not hearing my voice for the rest
of
the
evening. Wait a minute. He didn't give away your address.
What happened?
Demetri Moreland or my home address. Never. That's it.
Scaremaster, you need to stop all these spoilers.
Spoilers?
Yes.
I'm done with that cocksucking faggot. Fuck. I want nothing to do with him. I want him never to reach me again. He calls me constantly.
He calls you?
Calls me constantly and brags about, oh, he wants to move into my home address.
So you can understand,
name it.
But you can understand how that's a mixed message you're giving him right now.
Mixed message?
Exactly.
The mixed message is there's only one message. Don't ever reach me again. One, don't ever call me again. Two, don't ever email me again. Well, I blocked him on my computer, so he can't get through. Unless he's got a completely different name with a completely different fucking
name. Hey, maybe you should contrary the fact that he likes you.
He does okay, like he you.
Okay, he likes me. I'm
okay,
a great actor.
Okay, and here's someone else who likes us. Oh, you are a great actor.
You know, I'm watching you during these clips, and you seem upset by this whole thing. Why?
Because it's ridiculous. It's stuff that is way over 20 years old, and it's like,
no,
move
not
forward.
Everything's way over 20 years
well,
old.
Well, this bullshit is.
The one thing, no, he's into you now, not 20 years ago. He likes you now. He's trying to make things with you
he's
now.
He's trying to fucking get together with me sexually. It is never, ever, 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 ever going to happen.
All right, let me ask
period.
You this. Let me ask you this. Earlier, you spoke with Demetri on the phone. Now, you didn't get a chance to tell your side of the story. Why don't you pretend Demetri is right here? No one's going to interrupt you. Tell Demetri what you'd like to say.
You're out of your fucking mind, you dipshit. There's no fucking way you're going to have sex with me in a gay fashion, in a gay way, or any gay fucking... my mind just went blank. There's just no fucking way you're going to jerk me off, suck me off, or fuck me in the ass. It is not going to happen. Do you understand me, Demetri? Get it through your thick skull. I'm a man born and created for women. End of story. Over and out.
Okay, let's go back to some more $10 shoutouts from Demetri Moreland.
$10 shoutout!
Here's one, but this one says, please have Perry read this letter. Here you go. Why don't you read it with pride?
All right. Please have Perry read this letter. Dear Perry, thanks for the shoutout. On the last podcast, you said I need to... Wait. You said all I need is one fucking nut named Demetri Moreland to have his face at my house, and then you started screaming like a maniac about cocksucking faggots. Sounds like you're really frustrated with all the faggy dudes that keep showing up at your apartment who only know how to blow a dick. And you need a real man like me to give you the hardcore anal love that you need so badly. I promise you, Perry, that when we finally meet up, I will pound your ass so hard that it will measure on the Richter scale. I'm going to finish reading this, and then I'm going to give you my advice.
Okay.
When is the big chili cook-off at your apartment going to be? I'll bring all special vegetarian blend chili that has been laced with male hormones, Viagra and amphetamines so that we can get all the fans really horny and end the day with a glorious man-on-man orgy. I know there are a few non-gay fans, but we still need you guys on decks for our 1,000-man Buckcane... Wait. bucket cake, where we round up 1,000 men who will all ejaculate on the Scaremaster's face. Love, Demetri Moreland. You know what, Demetri?
He likes you, Scaremaster.
You know what,
first
Demetri?
Off,
let
that
me
was really nice
something.
Of him to say a lot of those
let
things
about
you.
Let me explain
about
something
about
Demetri
Moreland. About how much he likes you and how much he's going to do stuff to you.
I'll explain
and I'll
something
tell you
about
something
Demetri
else.
Can I just ask you a quick
really?
Question?
I'm
going to
explain
something. Let me just ask you a quick question. No, before you say anything.
Before
you say
anything,
let me just say this. I want to make a quick comment. Perry, no, let me just say this. The only time that you even stopped her said anything was when you said 1,000 men will ejaculate on the Scaremaster.
That was the
face.
Only part you had
the
a
only
problem
time that you had a
problem. But you know what I liked is that the rest of stuff
letter,
you used to not like to be
because I said
Moreland.
In the beginning
now
of that
like
letter,
them.
I'm going to finish
what's
this
the next
straight
one?
Down. Because
all right,
I
let
knew
me read this
Demetri
next
Moreland.
Letter. Oh, you knew?
Because I looked.
You guys have a thing.
I don't
you guys
have
got
shit
a thing.
For that fucking
you got
prick.
A thing.
I've got nothing no. For him.
It's adorable.
Look.
You're to the point where you're
look,
now thinking and
Lydia
understanding.
Lydia Torres
finish each
is going to be spending the weekend
you guys
with
finish
me
each other's
the 26th through 26th, 27th, 28th, 29th, 30th. Yeah. 4 days.
Sentences.
Yeah.
Friday she's coming in and she's going to be with me till Monday.
Yeah.
And she's going to help her mom find a place Saturday, so
okay.
She'll be with her mom Saturday.
Okay.
But I mean, I've
what
got
does that have
I've
to do
got
with
Lydia
this
and I
all right, let me read the next
four
letter.
Fucking days.
Let me read the next
okay?
letter. Okay?
You got a fucking problem?
I don't understand what your point is on the whole
well,
thing.
The point is okay. I don't fucking do any faggot shit.
Well, you got the time. You work some time
out.
I know
what happened
21
years ago. Happened 21 years ago.
Oh, that's right.
It's over. It's almost 21 fucking years.
All right.
I don't even want to remember the date or the.
Who do you like more, the guy from 20 years ago or Demetri Moreland?
No comment.
Oh.
Because it's ignorant question. It's an ignorant question.
No,
I don't like
shy.
Either one of them.
Yeah, then why can't
I don't want either one of them in my life.
All right, which one do you hate the most?
I hate them both the most.
But if you had to say one over the other. The guy that you hate the most.
The one, the guy that I hate the most is the guy that fucking raped me 21 years ago.
You like Demetri.
I don't like
it.
Demetri because Dimitri's not going to come near me. Demetri is not going to come near me.
He can, in a tree.
Demetri Moreland. Like hey, bag fuck. Before I come over there and beat you in the
$10 shout out.
Okay, this one says, please have Perry read this letter. Here you go.
Hey, Perry, it's your friend and long-distance, you're no long-distance lover. Demetri Moreland again.
Oh, it's
I know
nice
how
to
much
hear from
a music enthusiast.
Is it Demetri?
And I know how much of a music enthusiast you are, and I want to let you know that it's something we have in common, as I used to be in several Chicago area bands. In the early 2000s, I decided to write a song to commemorate the love that we share between us. I do not share any love between you.
Feel good?
Are you all right?
That apple cherry wood tobacco is strange.
Okay, I'm still working on the lyrics, but this is what I have so far.
Mary Jane, you want
homosexual
something?
Is the way to be. Randy Callahan isn't got shit on me. Fucking all day and all night. Hey, hell yeah, Perry's ass. Go fuck yourself, pal.
Just read it. Just finish reading it.
Oh, my God. Perry's ass is so tight. Gonna show you I'm a man. Gonna squirt in your mouth and on your hand. Gonna overflow your rectum with my man. There's no fucking way you'll ever touch me.
Is he
me.
Staying with you when he's
out? He's not coming. Why and if he fucking comes,
he
he's not allowed.
Come. He better
if
come.
That faggot comes to the fucking
you are gonna
here,
treat him like
he
a gentleman.
Not allowed in my house.
Why not?
Even if he pays $5 billion.
That seems excessive.
Yeah, some guys are getting in there for 500.
Now, gonna overflow your rectum with man gravy, just like Cookie Caramello in the
hey,
U.S. Navy.
Nice shot.
Fuck off, faggot. Because you know I can't resist this virgin. Look, jackass.
He likes you.
Find a woman, you fucking fag.
He likes you.
Wait. I used the wrong word. Find a lady. Become a man.
Why don't...
For women.
Why doesn't Stop Kyle Dickey hang out with him?
For gay guys.
Oh, look at this. Kyle Dickey.
Kyle Dickey could hang out with Demetri. Those guys would get along great.
Well, Kyle Dickey is not going to be at the podcast or at the show.
Why?
Because he's in San Francisco.
Well, maybe he can come down for the...
We should really invite Kyle Dickey.
Let's get him a plane ticket.
Just one look and I'll be a full mast. See, slipping my big cock across... If you're going to slip your cock across someone's face, let it be a chick's face, you flaming homosexual. I'll spread my anus, and you can give it a... No, I'm not going to give your anus a taste, or your fucking... No fucking way. Okay. Hot milky semen all over your lips. Tell me, Perry, does it get any better than this? No, it'll never get better than this.
Because no,
I'm not into men.
What a nice compliment.
I'm into women. I was thinking we should...
What would you do if you were in jail?
If I was in jail, I would bitch and cry until I get my own cell. I was thinking we could make it into a duet. Maybe in the next verse, you can sing about how you're going to give me one of those legendary Randy Callahan-style milkshake peach. I never gave Randy Callahan a milkshake BJ, okay, you flamer?
Hold on just a second.
And
hold up, Perry.
Wait, let me finish. How are you going to give me an epic rim job? I'm not giving you no rim job. I don't want to impose, but maybe you could convince Don to let us sing it together on the big October 11th live show.
All right.
No fucking way.
Maybe you guys should do Love Will Keep Us Together.
You guys have got to rehearse it. No, he's thinking about doing the song that he just read.
No fucking way.
I like it.
What do you think? What if he paid money? What's the amount of money that you would use?
What did I say? $5 billion? No, that was
to go in your apartment. How much to sing the song?
A pretty song.
Oh, man.
Are you okay?
No, I'm not.
Well, that was today.
I'm disgusted. I'm just fucking disgusted.
For with who?
Well, with everybody.
With me?
For allowing him.
Me?
Christ. What did I do?
What did I do?
Mary Jane?
What did I do?
The big three.
Okay. God. Wait, hold on. What's your deal, dude?
I am so opposed to the homosexuals trying to come on to me so fucking much.
It is a little flattering, though. You got him. It's a little flattering.
It's got to be.
It's nice, when somebody compliments you and
all right,
shit.
So there you go.
But when you got a bunch of guys.
But they like you.
Saying they want to do gay stuff to you.
Well, you know, you're very.
I am not.
They find you attractive, dude.
Would you shut up when I'm talking?
You're not attractive? You don't
Thank
think
you.
We're just saying that they find you very attractive. And Demetri likes you. And you should be complimented.
Perry, it's not like he's at your apartment
bothering you. You guys should at least meet to see if there's anything there.
All he does is compliment you, say nice things. So he's a little lost in his make-believe world. You have to admit one thing. Now, Perry, be honest with me. You are an attractive guy.
Thank you.
You're strong?
Absolutely.
I'm weaker than fuck.
But you're stronger than most guys.
You were just on top of me trying to mate with me. And you were really strong.
I wasn't on top of you trying to mate with me. I saw you before the show.
Yeah, really? The second I put our shorts together and go, we're shorts buddies, 30 seconds later,
Go away.
We're doing a podcast.
You
can't
away.
Go away. Now, you are an attractive guy that people are going to look at. Guys, women.
Mostly guys.
They're going to fantasize about you. You can't blame them. You're an alpha male, for God's sake.
I'm a man for women.
Okay, fine. Do you think Brad Pitt has guys that are attracted to him?
Of course.
Yes. So guys are going to be attracted to you guys.
This is hilarious.
Why is it funny?
Because this fucking Demetri Moreland punk just does not stop.
No, he does not stop. I agree with you.
It's like, you know, a bunch of little kids in a playground with, like, somebody keeping, for example, a toy away from the other little kid and just will not give it back. That's kind of like a Demetri Moreland.
I don't know what you mean by that.
I mean, let's say you're with, like, let's say you're about 4 or 5 years old, okay? And you got a bunch of Hot Wheels, and you guys are all, you know, pushing Hot Wheels this way and that way and whatnot. And then all of a sudden, one of the 3 or 5 kids sees this one Hot Wheel that he wants and wants to keep it and takes it off of the ground or off the track and pockets it. That's a Demetri Moreland type.
I don't know how you put that together, but I do understand one thing. According to that phone call, he's kind of the opposite of you, where you love big breast.
I love big tits. I love a foxy lady. L-A-D-Y, lady.
How would you spell ladies? Let's say you had 2 of them. How would you spell
I-E-S.
That?
L-A-D-I-E-S.
Right.
I don't know. I'm just really just fed up with this guy's constant trying to do sexual favors to me. I mean, please, be an adult. Stop being a freaking child.
I don't think children go out of the way to try to get some man to blow them.
No. I'm saying
he does have an adult sense of attitude.
I'm using the word child in a wrong format. He's got this childish way about himself to where he wants to just be a little brat and not be a man. I want to be only sexually with women, ladies, one specific that I want to get close to again, or just period, just close to for the rest of my life. And I don't know if the one that I'm thinking of right now is going to be there for me for the rest of our lives. But if not her, then somebody else will enter the picture. But, you know, Terry or...
Or who?
Vicky or...
Okay, a lot of these people are not for real.
What are you talking about? Terry Anfuso's for real. Vicky Givens is real.
Okay,
Linda Johnson is and was real.
Has nothing to do with you.
Because she went back to Florida.
Right. Let's not get into that. All these make-believe girls that you have long-distance
make-believe
relationships.
Go on the internet and fucking look them up. Victoria Givens, she's all over
okay,
the internet.
Okay, I don't care, but she has nothing to do with you.
Lately, yeah. She hasn't had anything to do with me. She's busy with her other career.
And what's her other career?
She's a fucking massive hardcore porn star.
Is she really?
Yes.
All right, well, listen, enough of the hardcore porn star make-believe girlfriends you have. Let's move on with more calls from Demetri. Take it away.
$10 shout-out!
All right, I got another one. Here we go. Hello, Perry. It's your homosexual lover, Demetri Moreland.
Oh,
God.
Hold for
Get
applause.
The fuck away
Hold
from
for
me.
Applause.
Get the fuck away from me.
I'm glad you enjoyed the gift that I sent you. The fans informed me that after
what
the big
gift?
Show, at the big show, you used my artificial cock to put on a demonstration of your anal stretching technique in the parking lot.
I'm not interested.
Did you do that, really?
No.
$5, same as downtown.
What?
Let me read on. I want to let you know that I'm prepared to contribute the full $500,000 to fund anything. We just need to clarify the perks I'll be receiving as an executive producer of the project. Wow, we could do just about anything. He's going to put up all the money. We could do the movie and the reality series for that money. We only have a couple days left, Perry. Should we at least listen to what he's saying?
Go ahead and read.
Please. It should go without saying that during the filming, I'll be staying at your apartment. I think he's talking about you, Perry. Each morning he will wake me up with a blow.
He's not staying in my house.
He'll wake you.
This is show business,
This
is show business.
Perry, before you say no.
He's not staying in my house.
Listen to me. Do you understand if we had the project done completely with the money, he's willing to put up $500,000 for this. So at least
get the money first.
Okay, that's what we'll do. But let's listen to what he says here. I'll read on. It should go without saying that during the filming, I'll be staying at your apartment. Each morning, you will wake me up with a blowjob.
Sorry.
And cook me breakfast.
Sorry.
at the studio, at least listen to what it's being said. Let me tell you this. If someone
I'm not gay.
Doesn't
There's
make
no
you gay.
Fucking way.
It doesn't mean you're gay. It means that you want to make the movie. That's the way I look at it. I wish he liked me. I'd suck him off as much as he wanted for $500,000 to make our movie.
Let him suck you off. Then.
I'd like to let that
too. Stop being weird, man.
At the studio, I expect you to walk fully nude when you're not filming scenes. Well, that's what he wants.
Well, just stay in your trailer and walk around naked there, and he can come hang out with you there.
He can want it all he wants.
And he also
wants gonna happen.
He also wants you to attend to all his needs, just like Burt Ward did for you on Windy City Heat, with more hardcore anal sex.
Oh, God. Fuck no fucking way. That's where I call it quits in show business.
Okay, well, at least let him hear what he also has to say. I would also like to be written into the movie as Stone Fury's gay lover.
It ain't going to happen because I'm not
How
gay.
How about Bone Fury?
There's no more.
Oh, that's a
there
great
is no
idea.
Fucking. Look, Stone Fury, if you think I'm going to play that, you're out of your fucking mind.
He's going to pay for the entire fucking
you
movie.
You are out of your fucking mind.
Well, let me see what goes on here. You know what? You should find out from Tom what it's like. It might not be that bad.
Oh, God.
It will not only be a great twist on the character of Stone Fury, but our passionate love scene will set a landmark as the first graphic depiction of a rim job in a major motion picture. Love, Demetri Moreland.
No. Fucking way.
First off, Scaremaster.
On planet
Scaremaster.
Earth, will I, in any way, shape, or form, go gay for anybody?
Do you have any idea
may
how
say,
negative that sounds?
Exactly. I don't give a flying fuck.
And may I say something?
Of course you may.
He likes you.
He does.
So like what? You. There's a lot of people that like me.
Quite a journey. Perry, did you have fun with that?
No, I didn't.
I thought it was fun. It's nice because he likes you so much. He likes you so much.
Look.
He likes you.
He can like me all he fucking wants to. He can email me on the shit.
All right, good. Okay, you guys can talk about that.
I'm not interested
in that. Talk about that later.
It's a guy coming on to this guy.
It
ain't going to happen.
We all know what it is.
Anyway, Demetri, anything you want to say before we go? By the way, some great $10 shout-outs.
Thank you for the $10 shout-outs, Demetri. I will admit to that. Yes, thank you.
Oh, Perry, coming around finally to the right side. Hey, how about you suck my big...
Fuck off, you fucker!
I think the problem might be is that Perry... that I'm not a Jehovah's Witness. But
no,
Perry,
that's not it. The problem
you.
Is that you're gay. That all you want
Perry,
is my dick down your throat.
I do. I want it so bad, Perry.
It ain't
going to
fucking
you.
Happen, you cocksucker.
I won't celebrate holidays. I won't salute the flag. I'll get on my knees.
You're a cocksucker, and that's the way it is.
Here, Perry, have a sucker.
Fuck off.
Well, anyway, I think that I see the hands on the wall in the general area where the clock is that we're running out of time.
Okay, one last question.
Okay, all right.
Scaremaster, and this is, okay, forget about that whole thing going on Carnival Cruise. But you two, as grown men, okay, you're a grown man, you just celebrated.
I'm not gay!
We get
how
that.
How many fucking times, for how many fucking years, do I gotta say, I'm not a homosexual? I'm not, and I'm gonna use this fucking word, I'm not a faggot! You got that, you cocksucker? I'm not gay!
I get it, but listen, let me ask you
so one. So stop! End the fucking story, you son of a bitch! Now pay me and get me the fuck out of here!
Demetri, how you doing?
Demetri, you okay?
Oh, I just came so hard. When Perry screams like that, it makes me fucking crazy.
I'm gonna have a heart attack.
Let me ask you,
this is making me sick.
Did you do that on purpose to make him hard?
Oh my God, Perry, you know just how to tease and please me, Perry.
I don't fucking care! Pay me, get me out of here! I'm gonna go crazy.
I'm jerking off again.
Okay, well, let's talk to you. If you want to get in touch with us on the social network, you can get in touch with me on my Twitter at SimplyDon1. Facebook, I'm at Don Barris. You can go on my Instagram and my... What's the matter? My Vine videos? Well, how can they get in touch with you?
I'm going off the grid for a while.
Okay. Perry? How can people get in touch with you?
Email me at scaryperryx1050 on Google.
Google?
Google.
Do you Bing? Okay. Do you do Bing also?
No, I don't do Bing.
Why not?
Facebook, Perry F. Caravello or Perry.Caravello.
And that's
K-A-R-A-B-E-L-L-O. Twitter, ScaryPerry818, and that's it. Over and out.
Okay,
Scare
Mary
Master,
Jane.
Why are you so worked up? And Dimitri's trying to tell you one last thing.
I think Dimitri broke Perry's heart.
Is that what it is? Go on. Tell them how they get in touch with you,
Dimitri,
Mary Jane.
He's really sad about you right now.
Smokey Mary Jane Twitter.
Okay, Dimitri, anything you want to say to Perry before we go?
I just want to say I love the Big Three podcast. I think I speak for all the fans when I say it's the greatest podcast on the planet. And Perry, I want to fuck you so deep, so long, so hard, you won't be able to sit for a few days after. You'll just be thinking of me, Demetri Moreland, your daddy, for days on end.
Okay, let's put it there. Everybody, Big Three!
Hey.
Goodbye!